Each of us has beliefs and values, and it has been predicted way back that World War III will be between believers and non-believers. Look somewhat right to as China, a non-believer, has been isolated from rest of the world. So here I will like to add up a famous quote of great writer Helen Keller. Never bend your head, always hold it high. Look the world right in the eye. Nine boys, I'm back with some more questions, and this time the chapter is matter around us pure, which is going on and has got over also. So what we are left with is to find different types of questions and to solve them time to time so that it can make your concept clear to clearer. And so boys, we are starting discussion over it. Question 1. How can you change a saturated solution to an unsaturated without adding any more solvent? Boys, the question looks very twisted, but it is actually not twisted. What is the query that has been raised in the question? That how you will make a saturated solution to an unsaturated solution? What is saturated solution? A solution in which the solubility has got over. An unsaturated solution in which you can add more salt and it will dissolve into it. So there are two ways to make saturated solution to an unsaturated solution: by adding solvents, like you have taken water and you have added salt in it. So salt is your solute and water is your solvent. So, and if the solution is saturated, and then and if you want to make it unsaturated, then what you will do, that you will add water. Then naturally more space will be created and more salt can dissolve in it. But the question says no to it, because it has been asked in the question that no, you don't have to add any solvent. So adding water is not a condition here. So in this situation, you can heat the mixture, because heating also creates a space between the particles of the matter, and the water molecule will start expanding and it will dissolve more solute and it will become unsaturated. Then I hope the queries will be solved. Now in the question number 2, based on which factor a solution is said to be diluted, concentrated or saturated? Boys, you have to just try to find out that how much solute has been dissolved in the fixed amount of solvent. If you have taken 200 gram of solvent, then what amount of solute you have added in the 200 gram of solvent? Then if it is less, then it will be your diluted. If it is more, then it will be your concentrated. And if it is right, then it will be your saturated. Diluted means it is unsaturated, it can dissolve more solvent. Concentrated means it has already dissolved maximum of the solute in it. And saturated means its concentration is right, means it cannot dissolve any more solute in it, and it has just got over it with its saturation point. What has been given in this question? That sucrose, which is also sugar, sucrose crystals obtained from sugar cane and beetroot. These are the two sources from where the sugar is obtained. It is prepared either from the sugar cane juice or beetroot juice, are mixed together. Will it be pure substance or mixture? And you have to give the reason. Boys, sucrose is sugar, and it has been collected from the two sources, that is your sugar cane and beetroot. But both are, and then we have mixed it together, the sugar obtained from beetroot and the sugar obtained from the sugar cane. But we are mixing sugar only, sugar to sugar. We are not mixing sucrose to sodium chloride. So then it will be a mixture, because then two compounds have been mixed. But here you are mixing just glucose to another glucose only. It will be a pure substance and nothing else. Now here, identify solute solvent in tincture of iodine. Solute and solvent, you have to identify in the mixture, which is your tincture of iodine. Tincture of iodine actually is a mixture of sublimating substance iodine and the volatile liquid salt, which is your non-aqueous solvent alcohol. So solute is always taken as the smaller volume, and the solvent is always taken as the bigger part, which is your larger volume. So alcohol is the larger volume, it is solvent, and the iodine is the smaller volume, so it will be your solute. Now What are the two components of a colloidal solution? The two components of the colloidal solution ideally, boys, are called dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Dispersed phase is nothing but the solute part which remains held up in the dispersion medium, which is the solvent part. This question: two liquids A and B are miscible with each other at room temperature, means they can dissolve into each other. The liquid-liquid mixture I refer to say with separation technique will you apply to separate the mixture of A and B if the difference in the boiling point is 27 degrees Celsius. So boys, remember about the simple distillation method and the fractional distillation method. In both of the separation method, we separate the miscible liquids only, mixture of miscible liquids only. But what is the difference in simple distillation? We separate the mixture in which the boiling point gap is more than 25 degrees Celsius. So here this condition is well applied because it has been given in the question that the boiling point gap is 27 degrees Celsius. So why we will go for the complex process instead? We will just do it by the simple distillation method. This question looks interesting, boys. Question number 8 is: an unknown substance A on thermal decomposition produces B and C. What is A? An element, a compound, or a mixture? Now you have to identify what is the nature of or what is the form of A. Boys, first of all, try to know that what is thermal decomposition. The thermal decomposition is nothing but chemical decomposition, which is done by heating. If you are heating the substance, it is breaking down into simpler substances, then it will be your thermal decomposition. So A is naturally a compound because it is breaking down into two substances, B and C. Why I am saying it? Because the mixture cannot undergo thermal decomposition because mixture is not a substance that it will break down into the simpler substances. Only a substance can break down into the simpler substances, and that's to only a compound because the element itself is in its atomic form and it cannot break down further. So neither it will be an element nor it will be a mixture. Only it is a compound and nothing else. Now identify the element from the following substances. Sulfur will be an element, definitely. Sulfur is an element. Its symbol is S. Brine looks like bromine. Don't get confused. Brine is nothing but a mixture, a highly concentrated mixture of water and salt. It's called brine. So just keep it in mind. It is not a element, but it is a mixture. Mixture of water and salt, simply saline solution, highly concentrated. Hydrochloric acid, it is also a mixture because the hydrochloric acid is the mixture of water with hydrochloric acid, which is a gaseous substance. Hydrogen chloride is a gaseous substance, HCl is a gaseous substance. It is dissolved in water and then it converts into an acid. So it is a mixture, it's not a element. Then your water is a compound, it's not an element. Neon is a element because it is a inert gas. Paper is just a mixture, it is mixture of cellulose with other some substances. Then sugar is a compound, it's not an element. So how many elements did you identify here? Sulfur and then your neon, nothing else. The last question is, identify colloids and true solutions from the following: pond water, fog, aluminium paint, vinegar, and glucose solution. Colloid will be your fog. Fog is a colloidal mixture. It is also called aerosol, which is the mixture of air with condensed water particle. Aluminium paint. Paints are always a colloidal mixture. They are emulsions type of colloid. Vinegar is a true solution. And glucose solution is also a true solution. Whereas pond water will be a suspension because in pond water lots of sand, soil, etc. also remains there. So it will settle down at the bottom. So it neither fulfills the criteria of solution nor suspension. So boys, had an interesting session of question answer and I hope that you might have enjoyed it and solve it.